Spend much of your time, we are going to go straight and ask Advocate Ashatse to welcome all of us. Advocate is the chairman of Renwater, which I was told it's more than 100 years old. I'm told it's 115 years old. So, colleagues, those who don't know, Renwater is one of the best managed water utilities in the world. The last time I checked, when we did an assessment, I was at the DBC in 2006. Renwater was rated in the top three of the best utilities in the world. I think we can give them a big round of applause. So without wasting time, I'm going to ask Advocate to welcome all of us.
Thank you, Program Director, Minister Sisulu, Minister De Leo, and all dignitaries. Allow me please to say good morning and all protocol observed. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, a very warm good morning to you and welcome. It is my privilege to welcome you to this very important event that many of the stakeholders in the room have been waiting for quite some time, I am sure. Under the leadership and guidance of Minister Sisulu, many hours have been spent by the technical people and ministerial advisors in preparation of this rightfully greatly anticipated document. We are here to listen and to learn about the master plan for the water and sanitation sector. Its intent is to transform the lives of South Africans, especially those that are still waiting for basic human rights and whose basic human rights are currently still compromised by the lack of adequate water and sanitation services. This document is hoped will get us to the equity and universal access that they are waiting for, in addition to addressing many other elements that need to be addressed and that impact the success and the efficiency and the performance of the sector as a whole. Water security is something that I think you will agree we all need assurance about. We all need assurance about the fact that the country is future-proofing our water resources and our water security. When we talk about water security, We are talking about having the right quality of water in the right quantity in order to be able to sustain life and health and to continue with the country's economic production and development, and to address nexuses such as water, energy and food production. I don't need to tell many of you in the room that water impacts on a whole lot of other sectors and their performance and production. So we will hear today about how the master plan addresses all of those things. Therefore, it is indeed a great day today, especially for those of us who work in the water and sanitation sector, as this document will guide us and inspire us and inform our actions. It is not only about words, it is about how those words turn into action that we would like to hear today in anticipation. I do not need to get into the details, ladies and gentlemen, or attempt to articulate the challenges that exist in our country, as many of you know them well, except to say that in post-democratic landscape, in this sector, it is characterized by both achievement and growing challenges. And this master plan is a roadmap about how to arrest, reverse, and turn the conditions around as far as the challenges is concerned, while strengthening those areas that do work well. There remain service backlogs in respect of water and sanitation that needs to be addressed. The maintenance of critical water and sanitation infrastructure is vital in order to make it work. And under the leadership of Minister Sisulu and those who have had the honor in preparing with her this master plan, we expect that they will inform us about how commitment to high service delivery standards and improvement of universal access will be addressed. This is done in conditions of great uncertainty when it comes to climate change and weather predictability. And that is also something that you need to, that you don't control, but you also need to manage to address. And we are all looking forward in anticipation to hear how this will be addressed. It is a document that, after all, will also lead to joint accountability, because we are all stewards of water resources in the country, and we should share in the accountability about how that is managed. And of course, that differentiates between those who bear the official responsibility for managing our resources and our infrastructure. We look forward to the direction that will be given by this master plan. Ladies and gentlemen, Program Director, I think that would suffice as words of welcome. Thank you very much for the attention.
There's a lot of research and development work that we do in the sector. We innovate in a number of areas, in sanitation, in wastewater treatment area, in raw water or potable water. Our Water Research Commission has done a lot of good work over the years. I'm now going to ask my colleague, the CEO of Water Research Commission, Mr. Disagan, to come forward and give us some few words.
Minister Sisulu, Minister Dilil, all the VIPs present, friends and colleagues, thank you for the opportunity to speak a little bit about the research component. A quick aside, Minister, I listened to the national anthem, and there's something that I didn't notice before, is that it has a specific section that's dedicated to water. It talks about the blue heavens, that's the source of our rain, the deep sea, and as soon as we crack desalination, this is going to be our endless source of water, and the Ewige Gebergte, the mountain ranges that are in fact our water tanks. So I think that every time people stand up and sing about this country through the anthem, they are celebrating our water heritage. The challenge of water is a South African one, we know this. The South African challenge is also expanded to a global challenge because the world as a whole is moving rapidly towards more and more water stress, and this is on the back, as you know, of climate change and population development and the development pathways we have chosen. But I can also tell you that there's been a big and sustained response from the global RDI community, the Research, Development and Innovation community. In fact, for the past 20 years, every single year, the amount of publications associated with water research expressing new science in this domain has grown by almost 30% per year. So there is an engaged partner in this enterprise. In the South African domain, I'd like to remind you that South Africa does very well in this space. The South African Water Research and Development and Innovation Community, which is approximately about 3,000 individuals from all of the universities, all of the public research institutions, and many of the private ones, are in fact highly productive, to the point where on the scales that we count, we are in the top 20 of research production in the world. And we are hopeful, and the master plan already starts talking about this, is that the new way we're going to be managing water going into the future is going to take more and more advantage of the research that we have developed, that the research that has been developed by our international partners, because we have a genuine opportunity to future-proof our water security, as CDS mentioned, on the back of the science and technology that already exists today. This is even before the new work that we're planning to do. And some of those features I want to emphasize very briefly. One is the concept of new sanitation. And for those of you who have been following the events, both locally and globally, this is becoming a fantastic new platform around, on the one hand, providing the essential services to folk, which we need to do, but on the other hand, organizing to save for up to 30% of freshwater resources that we currently waste with the current way we do it. The second big revolution we're looking for is the wastewater treatment revolution, organizing for us to really use wastewater as a valuable part of the water mix going into the future. And on the back of that, getting multiple benefits, like energy benefits and other beneficiation. We're also looking forward to South Africa actually being one of the lead countries in the world around recycling and the purple pipe revolution. We think we are at the stage where we worked out the science. We've got some of the innovations already being demonstrated on the ground. It's now about the scale up. And of course, associated with this is the general expansion of water supply. So Minister, the fourth industrial revolution, which some people talk about as a theoretical concept, is very real. It is already with us. And we need to then take the advantage that is available around the digitalization of the way we manage water, the use of artificial intelligence and how to do that efficiently, and a mechanism to empower all of the water users and stakeholders in our system. So in conclusion, I'd like to assure you, and I'd like to assure everyone in the audience, that you have a partner, both in the South African Water Research, Development and Innovation Community, as well as our own international partners, because we all are very keen to help you to make this work. So good luck. Thank you.
Thank you, CEO. That was very short, straight to the point. We want you to continue with the good work that your organization is doing. We are now going to bring forward Minister Delisle. Minister Delisle has to leave. She's not going to be with us throughout the day. She has other engagements to attend to. Minister Delisle and Minister Sisulu are in the economy cluster. Together, they are in the economy cluster. They also serve in the Interministerial Committee on Land Reform. As you know, that we issue licenses to all the infrastructure projects that the country is initiating. We have been put extremely under pressure to be a little bit more efficient in managing the issuance of the water licenses. We presented last week to the IMC the role that water as a sector plays in supporting emerging farmers. And there were quite a significant number of questions that were raised in that meeting by Minister Tilish and other colleagues in the meeting. Without wasting much of your time, colleagues, I'm going to ask Minister Tilish to address us, and then we'll play another video immediately after that.
Good morning, goeiemôre, dumelang, assalamu alaikum. Minister Lindiwe Sisulu, all our deputy ministers that are here, our public representatives, representatives from the business sector, I want to thank Minister Sisulu for inviting me to this very important occasion where she is going to present to us the country's master plan on water. Water is very precious and it's a scarce resource, and therefore all of us need to protect and conserve water. South Africa is a water scarce country, and many parts of our country have already felt the serious impact of climate change, and where we can see now the new normal is drought. Droughts mean that we have to fundamentally change our relationship with water. Because water simply doesn't come from a tap. Climate change brings great uncertainty and drastic changes in our weather patterns, leading to events like droughts and also wildfires. It is the greatest problem facing the whole world today. And we can all together tackle it effectively. Climate change also means that we no longer plan using the old methodologies. It requires bold changes and sometimes simple changes. We can all make in our everyday lives to conserve water. We can no longer also only rely on rainwater to fill our dams. We have to save water and we have to reuse water. While there's a role for everyone to play, one of the most effective ways to adapt to climate change and water shortages is to use water sparingly, because we can only save water while we have water. The tendency is that we want to save water when the drought is there already. We have to save water now. So building more dams alone won't solve the problems, because we need rain to fall in to fill those dams, and our water scarcity is as a result also of reduced annual rainfall. We have to tap into underground water, into our aquifers. But we need not replenish that resource, and therefore we need to make sure that we don't deplete it by replenish it with treated wastewater. As you all know, in the sixth administration, the Department of Public Works has been reconfigured to include infrastructure. And so the Infrastructure Act of 2014 is the leading piece of legislation that is guiding us in the country as to how to manage and deal with our infrastructure. But arising out of the Infrastructure Development Act, is there's also Presidential Infrastructure Coordinating Council that is coordinating and bringing all sectors and government together to drive our infrastructure plan. So I'm here today to work with Minister Sisulu, because our country has got a lot of aging infrastructure. And we need to repair and maintain our infrastructure while at the same time we are building new infrastructure. We need to look at the water leaks all over the country, and I'm sure the minister will declare war on water leaks so that we don't waste that resource. In terms of water resource security and to ensure availability of reliable water resources in the country, government will be investing in a number of water resource infrastructure projects. Some of the projects that government already involved in, it is currently being implemented, is the Clem William Dam and of course the Lesotho Highland Water Project Phase 2. Other projects such as the WIP in Limpopo, Mkhwanazi in KZN, Mkolo Crocodile Water Augmentation Project Phase 2 in Limpopo are also all in advanced stages. What we are planning to do in the next 5 years, as far as infrastructure is concerned, we will focus on bulk water and sanitation infrastructure projects, and we will prioritize the rollout and provision of water infrastructure to ensure availability of clean water to all South Africans. Some of the projects that we will include for the next 5 years include the completion of 20 wastewater treatment works, 32 water treatment works, and 38 bulk storage infrastructure projects, supported by over 1,600 kilometers of bulk pipe to distribute water to municipalities for recirculation. The Presidential Infrastructure Coordinating Committee will work together with the Department of Water and Sanitation to ensure integrated planning of the full water delivery systems of dams, pipelines, treatment works, and reticulation in the planning and implementation of water projects. Already in the past month, the Presidential Infrastructure Coordinating Committee has visited over 77 projects implemented under the Regional Bulk Infrastructure Grant with an estimated value of over 20 billion rand and a potential impact of benefiting almost 1.5 million households. The PICC will also keep on monitoring and of course tracking all of these projects, and we will work together with the department and the minister to ensure project delivery on time. We must also use this opportunity to retrofit and invest in water-saving technology and devices, and to make our buildings, especially our public buildings and private sector buildings, more water-wise. Because not only will we save water, but we will also save money. Using aerators on taps, I'm very impressed with what I've seen outside here today. Water tanks to harvest rainwater and grey water for irrigation. I think we are getting long past the time where drinking water should also be used for gardens. We all have a role to play and we all need to work together. In conclusion, we know that the drought is upon us. I think of my experience in the city of Cape Town between 2016 and 2018, where we had to manage the worst drought in 100 years. I think there are many lessons to be learned, and if we all work together, we can certainly, with the master plan, plan more, plan together, and walk this road together. And if we have everybody on board, we can certainly begin to change the South Africans' relationship with water and how to save water and how to navigate water and to use it sparingly. Minister Sisulu, I look forward to working with you in this field. It's something that's very close to my heart, and I think that with all the support of all the private sector and all the other bodies in this field, we are on the right track under the leadership of Minister Sisulu, and let us all now just put urgency into what we are doing. I thank you very much and God bless.
Ladies and gentlemen, another round of applause for Minister Kumuyi. As you all know, Minister Dilip is responsible for the Presidential Infrastructure Coordinating Committee. We submit all of our infrastructure projects to that coordinating committee, the Presidential Infrastructure Coordinating Committee. Let me acknowledge the presence of the ambassador from the Netherlands, Mr. Anne Peters, is here with us today. Netherlands, yes, he's sitting right there in front. They have assisted us a great deal in the Blue Deal project. We have quite a number of partnership agreements with the Netherlands. In fact, we had a meeting a fortnight ago with the ambassador, and we met and the ambassador's team about a fortnight ago in Amsterdam. So we have a solid partnership with the Netherlands.